Hello, it's Carly McAvoy. Talking about relative error, percent of error, and tolerance, we already talked about the first two things in the last video, so we really just have to talk about tolerance in part two. The tolerance or part of a component, the tolerance of a part or component is the acceptable amount that it can vary from its intended size. Let's say you're to cut a steel rod that's to be 11 3/8 inches long, and the plans say plus or minus 1/32 next to the measurement. This means that there's a tolerance of 1/32 of an inch. So then the question is, what would be the acceptable range of lengths for this steel rod? If your rod was 12 inches long, would that be okay? Are you within the range or not? Well, what we want to do is establish what the upper limit is, and then we'll establish what the lower limit is. Now, I can do this in my head. Maybe you can't, so we're going to put it down on paper. It's okay to do things in your head, or to do them on a calculator is fine as well. 11 3/8, well, I know that 8 goes into 32 four times. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply the denominator by 4 and get 32, and then the numerator by 4 and get 12. And then I can add that 1/32 onto that very easily. 12 plus 1 makes 13, so the upper limit is 11 13/32. That's the upper limit that would be acceptable with the tolerance of 1/32. So the other one is, what's the shortest acceptable lower limit? And then I'm going to do the same thing, except I'm going to subtract the 1/32. So I'm going to make that 11 12/32, and then I'm going to subtract 1/32, and that's going to give me 11 11/32. So my upper limit is 13 32, my lower limit is 11 32, the whole number 11 is staying the same there. What the difference in these numbers gives us the range, which is called the tolerance interval. So those are the ranges of acceptable lengths. So all we have to do is say 11 13/32, which was the upper limit, subtract 11 11/32, which is the lower limit, and 13 minus 11 is 2/32. However, we want to reduce 2/32 because 2/32 can be reduced to 1/16. Remember the things that I was asking you to do on the verbal fraction test. We were trying to reduce things in our head. We were trying to double things and half things, and kind of understanding those kind of things are really important, because you can start to do some of that in your head and save yourself some time. We'll see how that doubling thing is going to help us in a minute. Let's look at the examples I have. Again, could have made a bigger boxes here. I don't know why I didn't, but I didn't. So let's work with the boxes that were given. So what we want to do on all of these, given our measurement and given the tolerance, we want to find the upper limit, the lower limit, and the tolerance interval. So I have 3.5 as my measurement. My upper limit's going to be 3.5 plus 1/8. And my lower limit is going to be 3.5 minus 1/8. And that should make sense to you. We're just subtracting or adding that amount to find those two limits. So 3.5, well, that's actually 4/8, right? That's something we want to be able to do, is build and reduce fractions. And then we have 1/8. And so that gives us 3 5/8. Now I'm going to take the same thing, 3 4/8, but I'm going to subtract 1/8, and I'm going to get 3 3/8. My tolerance interval is 3 5/8 minus 3 3/8. And that's going to give me 5 - 3, which is 2/8, but what is 2/8 reduced to? It reduces to 1/4. Now here's where I want to talk about this thing about doubling. Remember when I asked you on the verbal fraction test to double 1/8? If you were to do double 1/8 in your head, doubling 1/8 is actually 1/4. Your tolerance interval is going to go 1/8 down and 1/8 up. That's actually 2 1/8. So we can double 1/8, and we can know what our tolerance interval is just by doubling that number. Up above, when our tolerance was 1/32, well, what's 1/32 doubled? Well, take it times 2, and what happens? The 2 cancels that 32, and we get 1/16. So we can find the tolerance interval just by being able to double a fraction. So it's interesting. I mean, it's useful to be able to do that without having to run and get a calculator. I'm not as good with decimals. Fractions are pretty easy for me. Okay, so my upper limit here, 1.19, I'm going to add 0.005, or 1.19, I'm going to subtract 0.005. Well, when I do that, I would use a calculator, and I did it earlier, so I can tell you what that is. That's 1.195, and this is 1.185. And so if I were to subtract those two things, guess what I get? I get 0.010. What is this double? Well, 5 doubled is 10. So what's happening here is the same thing. We're just doubling that to get the interval. Kind of nice, huh? All right, so that means what do you think the interval is going to be for this one? Well, we're going to go 2,000 down and 2,000 up. So what's the interval going to be? It's going to be, right, 4,000, because we're just doubling that. So our interval, we know already, is going to be 4,000 volts. So all I have to do to find the upper limit is add 2,000 and get 26,000, and then subtract 2,000 and get 22,000. And then I can see 26 minus 22 is how I get the 4. So we can get the upper and the lower by adding and subtracting the tolerance. And now I would ask you, what do you think the tolerance interval is going to be when you have plus or minus 1/28? Well, it's going to double that. And if you double a fraction that's an even number on the bottom like that, all you do is cut that denominator in half. What's half 128? It's 1/64. That's going to be our tolerance interval without having to do the subtraction. Instead, I'm doubling that. That's an easier way to do it. If I want to add 9/64, I don't know why I'm writing there, to 1/128, I would say, well, 64 times 2 is 1/28, and 9 times 2 is 18, and that would give me 19/128. And on the other hand, if I took 9/64 and subtracted 1/28, then I would say again, that's 18/128 minus 1/28, and that's going to be 17/128. And maybe now you can see once you get, there's some shortcuts. Maybe you'll see some better, even more shortcuts. Definitely the interval I'd like you to see. If you just double your tolerance, you get your interval. But the upper and lower you can find this way, or maybe you'll find some nice shortcuts that will help you. All right, have a fantastic day. We'll talk to you next time.